apartment.
Hey there, I'm a tenant, and I just have a general question about the toilets here.
Oh, sure.
I was wondering, like, I've been flushing tacos down the toilet, like, in the in the wrappers, like, directly from Taco Bell, like, over 50 of them. And it was going fine at first, but now it's just like it won't flush anymore. Like
flush a taco down the toilet?
Yeah, see, I'm flushing right now, and it just, like, it overflows. The water's going over the edge, all over the floor.
Well, stop trying to flush it.
Okay, well, I'm trying to get them to go down.
Well, stop trying to get them to go down.
Okay, well, I still have, like, over a dozen left. Like, most of them
went... Don't try to put any more down the toilet. That's not what the toilet's for.
Okay, well...
Especially if it's in a wrapper.
Yeah. Well, no, it should be able to handle the paper. It's just paper. It's like toilet paper, right?
No, because it's covering something solid and keeping it intact.
It's not that solid. They're just like the basic taco. They're soft tacos.
Well, it's still not something I would put down the toilet. I mean, that's what the trash is for.
Yeah, well, I do a YouTube channel called Will It Flush? And every day I flush like a different crazy thing down the toilet. And I get a lot of views on the channel. So
which apartment are you in?
That's what this is for. I'm just...
Which apartment are you in?
Well, do I have to tell you?
Yeah.
This is just a general...
If you've got water overflowing and on the floor, I think we need to know about it.
Well, no, this happens all the time. I always run into this issue. It's just usually I'm able to, you know, I just keep flushing. Like, let me try it again. Hold on.
Stop flushing it.
No, it's still overflowing. It's still going over the lid.
Stop flushing the toilet. Who are you?
This is Roy. But I just do a YouTube...
Roy who?
Roy's your bell. I do a YouTube channel called Will It Flush. Like, if you look it up on YouTube, it's a really popular channel.
And okay, you're messing with me, aren't you?
No, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah, I think you would. What's your full name?
Roy Gerbel.
Yeah, you're not one of our tenants.
No, I wouldn't be on the lease. I wouldn't be in the computer. I'm a roommate here.
Okay, which apartment are you in?
Okay, forget it. It doesn't matter. I thought you could help me, but I guess you don't have any advice about this? Other than to not...
Well, my first and foremost advice is quit flushing things like that down the toilet.
Now, I've been doing this for months, though. I've been doing this like...
I don't care what you've done in the past. Stop doing it.
Because I have like over a dozen tacos still. And like
don't put them down the toilet.
This isn't the worst thing I've flushed.
I don't care. I don't care what you've done in the past. Stop flushing non-poop down the toilet.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be difficult.
I think you are.
It's for my YouTube channel, though. It's just like, you know.
But if it's overflowing, it means stop flushing the toilet. We need to know which apartment to go to unclog the toilet.
Okay, I think I can handle it. Like, I have a plunger and everything.
I think we still need to know which apartment.
No, this is like this happens all the time. Like it's not that big of a deal. I was just hoping you might have some advice.
Yeah, it's that big a deal.
Okay, I was just hoping
if it's overflowing on a daily basis, this is a big deal.
Okay, because I mean I like yesterday I flushed Cheez-It crackers down the toilet. I've done like Happy Meals. I got sponsored once. I got a sponsorship. I flushed like a Fanta orange soda.
Yeah, but you don't have a lease with us, and you don't need to be doing that to our plumbing.
Okay, well, I don't think it hurts the plumbing. They're soft tacos. Because, like, I mean, I did like.
I don't think that's a call. If the toilet has been overflowing, you're obviously overworking it.
I don't know. It's like I did gumballs like a couple months ago. I did like I filled up the entire
bowl.
Okay,
bye-bye.
water pressure from your computer.
Do you put a Christmas tree in your toilet?
Do not flush those down the toilet. I'm just gonna keep flushing. Is it okay to flush puke down the toilet? You paid for the water, right? I put towels down.
And I don't flush sand down the goddamn toilet. Do not flush those down the toilet.
Thank you, Zombie Cat, for that intro song. Hi, everybody. You're listening to The Snowplow Show. I am your host, Brad. Today is June 11th, 2019, and we're at episode 561 of The Snowplow Show, which is just crazy. This one's brought to you by Teen Wolf Jesus, Xander Fett, Omni, SimSpeak, and Toiny Toiny. Those are five of the many people that support the show on Patreon and on Phone Losers and on that other thing. We've also got some new supporters recently, like Malty E, Nicholas D, Starkey, Anthony S, Brandon McSee, Jane Barbie's Ghost, Alexa Singh, Rumpled Foreskin,
Hell, I'm gonna proclaim
what the
no
fuck?
AI can touch my fame. They think they can rock me, but I'm light throwing shade. I put them all behind me like a software downgrade. It's bold, but I'm gold.
Holy
the
shit.
Story is true. They won't go the distance like me for you.
Okay, very funny new person whose name I will never say again. Anyway, Rumpled Foreskin and Hell Pike, thanks all of you for supporting the show. It's because of you that everybody is so behind on listening to episodes of everything, because thanks to all of you, I'm doing three shows a week at least. That reminds me, tomorrow I'm going to be doing a Hang Up the Phone show, which will be broadcast on Facebook and on the Mixlr called Is This Thing On? And on the PLA Shoutcast. I'll put links to all those in the show notes. If anyone wants to listen to that, Hang Up the Phone is our call-in show. You can call in and have awkward conversations with me and Fresno Carl and whoever else happens to be on with us. It's usually an okay time. In other news, I know I've been complaining about my asterisk system lately a few times, in case anyone is concerned about this, because it's been down for the past week. Nobody's been able to call in and hack answering machines, but it is officially back up. If you want to call into it, hopefully it will work. The phone number to call in is 914-296-1862. There are 11 answering machines hooked up to this thing that you can try and guess the code on, and you can change the message around. You can listen to all of the messages that have been left, and that might be fun for you, maybe. If not, there's a few other things on that line to play around with. I've almost got the call-in lines back up for tomorrow night's show. I can almost put this week-long nightmare behind me.
This is Mylon.
Hey, Mylon. This is Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Yes.
Hey there. I was just calling to let you know you need to. We're going to need you to cover up your windows on the front of your house during the day. The sunlight's been reflecting into the neighbor's windows, and it's bothering them.
Which neighbors?
I'm not allowed to say, but it's the one that you're reflecting sunlight into, and they think you're doing it intentionally. I know that's probably not true, but...
Wait a minute. Who are you from?
I'm from the Homeowners Association.
I really have no idea what you're talking about.
Okay, well, we just need you to put, I don't know, trash bags or something over the windows during the daytime, whenever it's sunny.
No, that's not going to happen.
Well, no, it has to happen, or we'll have to start fining you.
I'll talk to you later.
You can't be harassing your customers, sir. So I'm calling off of a really old list here. It's a Homeowners Association list that's located on a golf course. And I thought it'd be fun to use the Discord channel called Prank Call Idea Factory. That's in the PLA Discord, where people submit their ideas and just kind of steal ideas out of there. Because I have really been neglecting that place. I never steal ideas out of there. So that was the most recently saved idea, which was pinned to the top of the channel way back in July of 2018. That was from Chris B. Thanks, Chris B, for that one. I want to try that one again, because I don't think that guy believed it at all. So that's what I'm going to do for a while. I'm just going to call numbers off of this really old list and use random ideas out of the Discord.
Hello?
Hello, Jack?
Yes.
Hey there, it's Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to need you to cover up the windows on the front of your house during the daytime when it's sunny.
Yeah.
Well, because the sunlight's reflecting off of your windows and into the neighbor's house. It's bothering them.
Oh, is it?
Yes,
well,
it is.
I'll get right on that.
Well, you sound like you're not taking this seriously, sir. This is a very serious... Yeah. You can't be harassing your neighbors like this.
Well, they probably deserve it.
Yeah, well, you're going to deserve the fines that we give you if you don't do something about this.
Uh-huh. Yeah, well, I'll tell you what. Go ahead and send them over, and I'll just pay them like a good citizen.
Okay, it's happening. Don't think we won't do it.
Okay.
Motherfucker.
Go get them. You're an idiot.
I'm not. You take that back. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's not buying it either. This might be the dumbest idea ever, Chris B.
Hello?
Hello, Nancy?
Hello?
Hello, Nancy?
Yes.
Hey, Nancy, it's Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Okay.
And we're going to need you to start covering up the windows on the front of your house. I guess one of your neighbors has been complaining that the sunlight's reflecting into their windows out of your windows.
You're so funny.
Oh, no, I'm completely serious. Nancy, I don't think this one's going to work, Crispy.
Hello.
Hello, Marianne?
No, she's not here right now.
Oh, well, is this Diane?
Yeah.
Okay, this is Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Oh, okay.
We're just going to need you to start covering up the windows on the front of your house during the day.
Why?
One of your neighbors is complaining that the sun is reflecting from your window and into their window.
Well, then I'd like to complain about my neighbor across the street. Her when the sun hits her at night, it hits me in my house, so I don't want to hear about it.
Well, no, this is probably a different neighbor. Oh, man. Well, finally, someone took it seriously.
Yeah, what?
Listen, you need to get out there and just cover up those windows. That has nothing to do with this.
Which windows?
The front windows on your house. Cover them up with trash bags or something.
Why?
Because they're reflecting into other people's windows. You're being kind of a jerk neighbor.
No, I didn't know I was going into anybody else's windows. But when the sun goes down, the people across the street, it reflects into our windows. So until she puts hers up, I ain't putting mine up. This is the first time I heard about this.
Why is this
stupid.
Why don't you just close your damn blinds? Okay, there she goes again. That sucks that she wouldn't talk to me. Anyway, I think your idea is done, Chris B. I'm going to go ahead and unpin this one, and we'll move on to something else.
Hello.
Hey there, LaVon?
Yes?
It's Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Okay.
I'm calling to let you know that your mailman that you usually have?
Uh-huh.
He was in a minor accident, and he's going to be in the hospital for about 3 weeks.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, he's fine. He's fine. He just broke both of his legs.
Oh, goodness.
So you're going to need to go to the hospital from now on to get your mail.
You're kidding.
No, that's where the pickup's going to be. So he's going to be in room 304 at the hospital.
You're pulling my leg.
No, I wouldn't kid about something like this, ma'am. It's a very serious thing.
No,
it wasn't an accident.
No. Never mind. Don't call again, please.
But no, ma'am, do you want your mail? Well, she's not buying that one. Free chemo. That's free chemo's idea. I can't imagine anyone falling for this one.
Hello?
Hello, Patricia?
Hello, yes?
Hey there. This is Steve Dave. I'm with CenturyLink, the phone company. I'm calling to let you know we're going to be inserting 30-second advertisements in the middle of your phone calls. So just so you know, so you're not wondering what's going on, there's just going to be advertisements in the middle of your phone calls.
Why?
It's just another way for us to make money. It's just any phone call that's over 5 minutes. you're going to hear a 30-second ad every 5 minutes.
I see. Okay.
So just so you're aware of that, you should have gotten something in the mail.
When is this starting?
It's starting this coming Monday. So if you're ever on the phone for more than 5 minutes, you're going to start hearing ads. And we'd appreciate it if you wouldn't talk over the ads. Don't try to yell over it. Just kind of sit there. It's just 30 seconds.
And you said your name was Steve Day?
Yeah, Steve Day from CenturyLink.
Okay.
So 30-second ads.
And so there's no way we can get out of this at all.
Oh, no. No, not yet. I think eventually they're planning to offer a premium service that lets you not have ads in your phone calls. Mm-hmm. But for now, they're going to make more money just by selling ads, and they're going to be in everyone's phone calls.
Okay. 30 seconds.
Yep.
After a five-minute phone call.
Yeah, every 5 minutes, a 30-second advertisement.
Okay. And your phone number that I can reach you if I need to?
Well, I don't have a direct extension here. I can give you our toll-free number for customer service.
Fine.
It's 1-800-19.
Okay. Your last name is Day, D-A-Y?
Yep, that's it.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a good day, ma'am.
You too.
Bye. Well, she seemed to believe that, but then she's getting my number. So maybe she's going to call and confirm first. I'm kind of hoping she's going to start calling up her friends and telling them about this. That's an idea from Seven. Thanks, Seven, for that one. He wanted me to get their ad preferences, like what kind of ads do they want, but I don't know. That's a lot of work. I mean, he does have examples in here, so.
Hello?
Oh, hello, Jim?
Yeah.
It's Steve Dave from CenturyLink, the phone company.
Oh, yes.
Hey there. I'm just calling to let you know, starting Monday, we're going to start inserting advertisements into your phone conversations.
Advertisement?
Yeah, yeah. If you're on the phone for more than 5 minutes, you're going to hear a 30-second advertisement. So I just didn't want you to be concerned about what that was. You're going to start hearing ads in your phone calls.
Why is that?
It's just a thing to help keep your bill lower. You're going to hear?
No, I don't want it. No.
Oh, there's no opting out. You have to have it. I'm just informing you that this is going to start on Monday.
Who is this from then?
CenturyLink, your phone company.
Uh-huh.
Yep, any advertisements. I mean, any phone calls longer than 5 minutes, you're going to hear a 30-second ad. And it's going to be, the advertisement's going to be based on whatever things you're talking about.
That's an invasion of privacy, isn't it?
Well, no, it's just the computers that hear it. It's not a real person that's listening. It's the computers. It's just keyword-activated advertisements.
Well, I don't want to have that.
Yeah, well, you're going to. Sorry.
CenturyLink, huh?
Yep, yeah. CenturyLink.
I don't have CenturyLink anyway.
Yeah, well, we own the phone lines in this area. So whoever you're reselling from, it's still us as the underlying phone company, and we put the ads on all the lines, even on cell phones.
My name's TBS.
Yeah, yeah. They buy the lines from us. They lease the lines. You've got a CenturyLink phone number, though. So we're going to be putting ads in all of your phone calls.
Why, that's terrible, huh?
Well, it's just for 30 seconds every 5 minutes. You could use a little break and just kind of think about products that you want to maybe purchase.
Well, when you're talking to somebody, it'll hang up on the other person?
No, it won't hang up on them. They'll hear it too. You'll both hear it. And you can yell over the ad if you want, but we'd appreciate it if you wouldn't do that. Just kind of sit.
How long are they going to do that for?
Forever.
It's awful.
It's just, it's the new thing. It's the latest in telephone technology. Yep. So.
Okay, well, thank you.
Just so you're aware of it, that's going to start on Monday. There he goes. These aren't even funny, really. I just love the idea that they're going to tell people. They're going to tell their family and friends about this. And they're all going to be like, what?
Vicky, may I help you?
Oh, hello. Is this Mary?
Hello. Yeah, it
oh,
is.
Oh, hey, Mary. It's Steve Dave from the Homeowners Association.
Uh-huh.
Calling to let you know your postman, right?
Yeah.
He's in the hospital for the next 3 weeks. He broke one of his legs.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he's fine. There's nothing to worry about. He's going to be laid up in the hospital.
Uh-huh.
But you're going to need to go to the hospital from now on to pick up your mail just for the next 3 weeks, maybe just 2 weeks.
Is this Dan?
No, it's not funny, ma'am. He broke his leg.
I know, but I'm not going to go to the hospital to pick up my mail.
Okay, you don't have to go to the hospital. He'll just bring it all at once when he's out of the hospital.
Well, what about the post office? Don't they have other people? Well,
yeah, but he's your postman, you know? So it's just him. So you don't have to go. It'll just pile up there while he's there. It'll give him more to carry out when he's recovering from his leg injury.
I don't think they're going to deliver him the mail in the hospital.
Oh, no, they definitely
aren't. This is a joke.
No, this is not a joke, ma'am. I'm kind of offended that you're laughing, to be honest. I know him personally, and he's a very nice person.
Maybe should. My husband's home during the day. Ask him to go get it.
Ask him. Oh, no, you ask him. I ain't your goddamn secretary.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, well, I hope you had a good laugh and everything, but I have other people to call on his route and let him know about this.
Okay.
So you have a nice day. Well, that didn't go too well. And I'm already done with this list. This is my third time calling numbers off of this list, where I've gone through the entire list. That's why it's so short this time. A lot of the numbers are already crossed out. So I guess I'm going to delete this list now. I've officially used it up. Thanks, whoever sent it. I forget who sent this one. And we're going to move on to this next list. Also a list that I don't remember where it came from. I'm just opening up documents directly from my DocHub account, so I don't see the emails that came with these.
Hello, this is Beth.
Hey, Bess. This is Steve Dave from Verizon Wireless.
Hi.
I'm calling to let you know we're going to be inserting advertisements into your phone conversations from now on. So just so you know, every 5 minutes you're going to hear a 30-second ad.
Excuse me?
Did you get the letter we sent out about that or the email?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm just calling to make sure you know, because starting on Monday, you're going to start hearing ads every 5 minutes. You know, just advertisements, audio advertisements in your phone calls.
Seriously?
Yep.
Okay. Sounds like a reason to switch companies.
Oh, no, everyone's going to start doing this soon. But we're the first. You're actually enrolled in the Early Adopters program. So we're letting you experience it before most other people do.
Experience it?
Yeah, it's going to be the newest thing. Everyone's going to do this.
Okay.
So just so you know, it's going to start on Monday. You're going to start hearing 30 seconds of ads for every 5 minutes that you talk.
Okay. Are you receiving any positive response to this news?
We don't receive really a positive response to a lot of things we do here.
Okay.
But, you know, for the most part, customers are kind of bitches. They just kind of have an attitude about every little thing. This is Steve Dave. I'm with the customer service department here at Verizon.
Okay. Well, have a good day.
Oh, thanks. You too.
Goodbye.
I think I gave it away by saying the B word. I shouldn't do that. I really like this idea. It has potential, I think. Thanks for this one, 7.
Hello?
Hello, Deborah?
Yes?
Hey there, this is Steve Dave from Verizon Wireless.
Yes.
And I'm calling to let you know we're going to be inserting advertisements into your phone calls starting on Monday. So every five minutes, every 5 minutes that you're on the phone, you're going to hear an advertisement.
Why would you do that?
It's just a new thing we're trying out. And we
don't do it.
Oh, no, we're definitely doing it. You're in the early adopters program.
I don't want to listen to advertisements on my phone when I'm in the middle of a phone call.
Yeah, well, they're short ones. And the person you're talking to, they'll be able to hear it, too. So it's not like it'll just go silent for them.
Don't do it.
No, we're
don't do it. I'm not allowing you to do it.
No,
don't do it.
We're going to do this for everyone. All right, another vote for no on the advertisements. I think this is a great idea. People don't complain when there's advertisements in their TV shows, right?
Hello?
Hey, Olga. This is Steve Dave from Verizon Wireless.
Hi.
Hey there. Calling to let you know we've enrolled your phone plan into a new thing where you're going to hear advertisements while you talk on the phone.
Okay, I'm in a conference call, so can I call you back?
No, just tell them to hold on. I mean, that's all I needed to tell you, really. You're going
to
hear advertisements.
I don't want to get advertisements on my phone.
Well, you're going to. That's what I'm saying. It's already done. You don't have to pay anything extra. It's free.
I don't want it. Well, who is this?
This is Steve Dave from Verizon Wireless. We went ahead and just activated it. So if you're on the other line, they're probably going to start hearing ads coming from your end. Whoever you're talking to. So get ready for that.
I'm going to call corporate to try to cancel that. I really don't want advertising.
Oh, well, no, there's no canceling it. We're going to do this for everyone starting at the end of the summer. You're just in the early adopters program. We put you in it early.
Okay.
So you can give us feedback and stuff.
Okay, I will look into it further.
Yeah, I just activated it, though, so you're going to hear it in about 2 minutes. You're going to hear an advertisement.
And I don't have a choice not to get that.
No, pretty much not. And whoever you're talking to on the other line, they're going to hear it, too. So everybody gets to hear the ad. And then you guys can talk about the ad.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Bye.
Hey, who are you talking to on the conference? Olga's going to go warn the people on the conference call about the advertisement that's getting ready to play. All right, I need to move on to something else, as much as I'm enjoying this one.
Hello.
Hello, Karen?
Yes?
Hey, this is Steve Dave. I'm with the post office here.
This is who?
Steve Dave. I'm from the post office. We deliver your mail.
Yeah.
You're going to get a new mail carrier starting on Monday.
Uh-huh.
And he's kind of a night owl. He's just going to be delivering your mail at nighttime. So do you think you can get some mailbox numbers that light up? Or they're at least glow-in-the-dark or reflective?
I don't know. I don't know where I get them.
Yeah, just go to the hardware store. Just go to a Lowe's or a Home Depot or whatever. Light up would be best. Huh? Light up would
When's
be
When's he
best.
Supposed to start?
Oh, he's going to start on Monday. And he's just kind of a night owl. He's going to be coming out and delivering your mail at like 3 in the morning.
Wow, that's weird.
Yeah, well, you know, he's on a different schedule than the rest of us.
Okay.
He's just, he's
so
not...
So you want us to get, huh?
He's not a morning person, he says. His name's Chuck.
Chuck, okay.
Yep, Chuck Bartowski.
Okay.
So don't be concerned with him with someone creeping around your house late at night or anything. He's just delivering the mail, that's all.
Well, he doesn't really need to come into our yard because it's at the
Well, you know, if there's a box the though. If there's a box, he might come up. He might have to knock.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So he might knock on your door at 4 in the morning. If there's a package.
And who am I speaking to?
My name is Steve Dave. I work here at the post office.
Steve?
Steve Dave. Yep. That's me.
Okay.
So,
And you're working, right?
Yep. That's correct.
Okay.
So, yep, just at least reflective letters on your mailbox so he can see. He doesn't want to have to shine a flashlight all over your property looking for your mailbox in the middle of the night.
Okay. Okay.
All righty.
Let's see what we can do.
You have a nice day.
Thank you for calling.
Uh-huh. Goodbye.
Bye.
Karen seems to have no problem with middle of the night U.S. mail deliveries. That's an idea from someone named Moon and Star on the Discord.
Hello?
Hello, Mrs. Durham?
Yes?
Hey, this is Steve Dave from the post office.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you're going to have a new mail carrier starting on Monday, this coming Monday.
Okay.
And he's kind of a night owl. He wants to do his deliveries after midnight. So he's going to be working kind of all night instead of during the day.
Okay.
So is there any way you could get some light-up mailbox numbers or glow-in-the-dark, maybe, so he can see better?
Well, I'm not sure, but I can ask. Our whole cul-de-sac is all on one mailbox.
Yeah, but it's still, he doesn't want to be shining a flashlight around there. And probably until that happens, he's going to be boxing it all in the wrong mailboxes because it's late at night, he can barely see.
Yeah. Well, we can see what we can do, the cul-de-sac, about getting reflective numbers or something on our...
Okay, that'd be great, yeah.
So is he taking Dave's place? Is that...
Yep, no more Dave. It's going to be all Chuck Bartowski from now on. He's...
Oh.
Yep.
Is Dave retiring?
We had to fire Dave.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, I'm not, after what he did.
Okay, well, probably not privy to it, so,
Oh, I'll tell you everything. He was tickling people.
He was tickling people?
Yeah, he's a tickler. Weird.
Oh. Huh. That's weird.
Yeah, yep, it was really becoming a problem.
I guess.
So if he has any boxes that can't be left in the in the box, he will be having to ring your doorbell at 4 or 5 in the morning. Just so you know, I know that doesn't happen a lot, but just so you're aware, don't be too concerned if someone shows up in the middle of the night with a package delivery.
Yeah, well, the regular mailman just leaves things on the porch and doesn't ever ring the doorbell.
Oh, okay. So. Well, that's not how you're supposed to do it.
He doesn't need to ring the doorbell. He could just leave it on the front porch.
Okay, all right. I'll let him know you guys are cool with that then.
Okay.
All right.
Well, thank you.
I hope you have a great day.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
Love you, bye. She's going to see Dave tomorrow. She's going to be like, wait a minute, I thought you were fired for tickling. I've been watching this show this week called AP Bio, and it's about high school teachers, and one of the high school teachers got suspended for tickling other teachers. So that's where that came from. The guy was a teacher tickler.
Hello.
Hello, Herman?
Yes.
Hey there, it's Steve Dave from the post office.
Uh-huh.
I just needed to let you know there's going to be a new... You're going to have a new postman on Monday morning.
Are you calling the right person?
You live on Apple Street, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. It's us that brings you your mail.
Why are you calling? get new people frequently.
Well, it's just that this new guy, his name's Chuck, he's kind of a night owl, and he's going to be delivering your mail in the middle of the night. Like, he's going to start his rounds right around midnight, and he'll be making deliveries all night, just during the dark hours.
Okay, so again, I appreciate the heads up, but I don't really understand it.
Okay, I don't know what's not to understand. You're getting a new postman, and he will be delivering things in the middle of the night. So you might have to ring your door. Yeah, you might have to ring your doorbell at 3 in the morning.
Oh, I don't want that.
Yeah, well,
why would he ring my doorbell at 3 in the morning?
Well, just if there's a box.
That'd be weird, because the postman has never rung my doorbell lived here. Lived here 14 years. That's
Herman,
kind of weird.
Herman, settle down. Just if there's a large package or something, for the most part, he's just going to be, putting the letters in the box. just like normal. Okay. It's just going to happen in the middle of the night. But
appreciate the heads up, but it's
sure.
No weird.
No problem. It's not weird. I'm just letting you know. I also need to let you know.
Well, it's very nice of you if it were legitimate here, but we get so many illegitimate calls. So,
you don't have to just assume that I'm one of them.
Okay, well, that's very nice.
So what I'm trying to tell you, you're going to need to get some light up letters for your mailbox so we can see at night.
Oh, that's what you're selling.
No, I'm not selling. I'm not selling
them.
That's
what you're selling. I think I'm finished with this call, so goodbye.
Herman, you idiot. I'm with the post office. God damn it, Herman. Fucking telemarketers. They make things so hard for prank callers these days. For us legitimate prank callers. I think I'm done with that idea for now. Thank you, Moon and Star. I am deleting your post. Completely deleting it. I'm deleting all of these ones that I use. Oh, hey, look at that. Chris B's idea about covering the windows in the daytime because they're reflecting. That was the first idea ever posted to the prank call idea factory. And I'm deleting it because I did it, you know? Sorry, Chris B. Just get over it, okay?
Hello?
Janelle?
Yes.
Janelle, hey. If you can hear this, I have something really weird to tell you. You're not on the phone right now. You've actually been in a coma for the past 5 years. And we just need you to wake up. This is Dr. Gerbel. We've plugged a microphone directly into your brain. You're in a coma. Just wake up. You need to realize you're not actually on the phone right now. And wake up. Wake up, Janelle. Oh, I don't think it's working. Oh, she just asked me who I am. This is Dr. Gerbel. I'm the lead doctor here on the fourth floor at the hospital. You've been here for 5 years. We just need you to wake up. It's not a joke, Janelle. You're not actually on the phone right now.
Who is this?
Dr. Roy Gerbel. Wake up, Janelle. Wake up. Your family misses you.
Okay. Give them my regards.
Just wake up. Please. Please wake up. It's not working. All right, whatever. Stay in a coma for another 5 years, Janelle. I don't give a shit. Easy paycheck for me.
Hello?
Hello, Cassandra?
Yeah.
Hey, this is Dr. Gerbel. This is going to be hard for you to believe, but you're not actually on the phone right now. You've been in a coma for the past 5 years. If you can hear me, please wake up. Just wake up. Your family misses you. Cassandra, it's not a joke. You have to realize it's not a joke. I don't know, Bearded Dave. Nobody's buying this for some reason. This is just like when I try to tell people I'd been miniaturized and put into their bodies. They just all laughed at me.
Hello.
Hello, Catherine?
Yes.
Catherine, this is going to be really hard for you to understand, but this is Dr. Gerbel, and you've been in a coma for the past 5 years. You just don't realize it. You think you're on the phone right now, but... really, you're in the hospital?
Give me a fucking break.
Holy shit. I was going to stop after that one, but after that response, I got to do at least one more, right?
Hello?
Hello, is Cheryl there?
No, who's calling, please?
This is Dr. Gerbel from the hospital.
She's in Seattle, for her appointment tomorrow. She's staying in Seattle tonight.
Okay. Can you call her up and tell her that she's actually in a coma right now? She's been in a coma for 5 years, and we've connected a microphone directly to her brain, and we're trying to get her to wake up. I don't know.
What are you talking about?
Well, look, I don't know who you are, but you don't actually exist. You're just a figment of her coma. Of her delusional coma dream
world thing.
Who the fuck are you?
This is Dr. Roy Gerbel from the hospital.
Which hospital?
Does it matter, really? It's the one...
You're a fucking asshole.
Well, that doesn't even bother me, because you know what? He's not even a real person. I don't care if a fake person calls me an asshole.
Hello?
Hey, baby.
Hello?
Hey, baby. Hey, baby.
Hey, who is this?
Hey, put Don on, please.
Put Don on?
Yeah, put Don on. Don't be a dick.
Who is this?
Don't be a dick. Just put Don on.
Hello?
Don?
Yes?
Don, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, listen. This is going to be hard for you to believe, but you've actually been in a coma for the past 5 years. We're trying to get you to wake up. You're in a hospital bed right now. We've attached an asterisk system into your brain so we can talk to you. And I think it's working. Can you hear me still?
Yes.
Okay, we need you to wake up. You're not actually on the phone right now. You've been in a coma for 5 years. Your family misses you. I think we're losing her. Dawn? Ah, crap. Dawn just flatlined. Okay, I'm done with that one. Thank you, Bearded Dave, for that idea. There was a couple of good responses on that one.
Hello?
Hello, is Donald around?
I know who's calling.
Sure, this is Roy. I'm your neighbor. I live across the street here in Watson.
Oh, yeah. Okay, just a minute.
Okay.
The phone for you, dear. Roy, across the street, neighbor here, wants to ask you. Yeah. Roy, or whatever.
Hello?
Hello, Donald?
Hello?
Hello, Donald, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can now.
Oh, okay, great. Hey, this is your neighbor. This is Roy. I'm over in that blue house.
The blue house?
Yeah. You know that tree in your front yard? The big one?
You mean directly across the street from us?
Oh, no, a couple houses down.
Let me go outside and have a look.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Donald, you know that tree in your front yard?
Yeah.
The bigger one? I've hired a company to remove that from your front yard, and they're going to transplant it into my front yard.
I only have one tree in my front yard, and it's a very small one.
Yeah, we're going to plant it. We're going to put it over here in my yard.
I don't want to lose my tree.
Yeah, well, you can get another one. I don't think so. I've already hired the company. They're going to come over and transplant it from over there to over here. They'll do a good job. They're not going to hurt it or anything. I just need some...
What's your house number, Roy?
Why do you need that?
Because I want to know which house we're talking about moving this tree to.
I'm in the blue house, just down the street. You don't need my address. I don't want you coming.
I think I do.
No, I don't think so. You'll know which one's mine because I'm going to transplant that tree from your yard to mine.
No, you're not.
No, I am. Because the sun, it gets in my eyes in the afternoons. So I just want to have a tree there to block it.
I think you're very well mistaken, because how big of a tree do you think you're talking about?
Well, no, it's not that big at all. That's why we can still take it out and move it to a new place.
That would be stealing a tree.
No, we're not stealing, because we're neighbors. And I'm having a company...
Nobody better show up and dig up my tree. So
yeah, but no, I'm having...
forget your plan.
No, I'm having a company...
Go to nursery and buy your own.
I've already hired a company to do it. They're going to be here tomorrow.
I don't care what you've hired a company to do. I'll tell them that they can't have it.
Well, no, I've already paid them and everything. So they're definitely going to take your tree. And they're going to move...
That's too bad.
They're going to move
it... Because you've lost your money.
They're going to move it to my front yard.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are. I've already paid them.
I don't care if you paid him.
I don't know why you're being a dick about this. I just need a tree for my front yard. We lost Donald. That's an idea from Symphonium
tell people the sun gets in your eyes during the day, so you're letting them know you've hired a company to uproot their tree and plant it in your front garden.
Good afternoon, this is Jenny.
Oh, hello, Jenny. This is your neighbor, Roy. I live here in Hogan. I'm kind of across the street from you.
Oh, hi. Yes. Hi, Roy. How are you?
Pretty good. Hey, you know that big tree in your front yard?
Yeah. I mean, we have several, so I'm not sure which one.
Oh, it's the one kind of in the middle-ish?
Of the front yard?
Yeah, the bigger around one. It's been there a while.
Okay.
I've hired a company to move that from your yard into my front yard. I'm across the street and a few houses down.
Okay. I'm sorry. I'm really confused what you're talking about.
Oh, the tree. They're going to move the tree out of your yard. They're going to transplant it. It's a professional company. They know what they're doing. They know how to do it. They've got equipment and stuff to pick it up and just kind of bring it over here and plant it in my yard.
Roy, why don't you come over and we can talk about this?
Oh, no, I'm just letting you know the company's going to be here tomorrow to do this. I've already paid them.
Why don't you come over to the house and let's talk about it?
For what, though? I don't have time right now.
Well, you're going to have to because, you know, nothing's going to happen like that.
Oh, no, I looked it up. That tree was originally in our yard when it was just first planted. And then they moved it. So legally...
Why don't you come by the house and you can... we can talk about it.
Oh, I don't want to come over. That's why I'm calling. I don't even have pants on.
Yeah, I don't care. You can come by when you're ready to come by and we'll talk about it. Otherwise, you know, no, nothing's going to be... Nothing's authorized.
You want me to come over without pants? That's weird.
You know what?
I'm not even...
I know that you are not Roy, so... this is a ridiculous conversation. You need to find something else better to do than this.
What do you mean I'm not Roy? Why would I not be Roy?
Well, then come over. What's my husband's name? Have you talked to him lately?
No, I'm just you can pass the message along to him.
Well, have you talked to my husband lately?
About what? Why would I talk to your husband?
Okay.
That's strike two on removing a tree. Everybody's so attached to their trees.
Hello,
Hal?
Friendly Hal.
Hey, Hal. This is Steve Dave. I'm with Royco Construction and Tree Service.
Okay, we're okay on trees here. No problem.
Okay, listen. I'm coming over tomorrow. We're going to be removing your tree. Your neighbor hired us to.
My neighbor is my son, I think. Is it a...
No, it's Adam. And we're gonna be picking up the tree out of your yard and moving it over to his yard.
this is a joke, isn't it?
No.
This is.
Why would
come on? You're kidding me, aren't you?
Why would I joke about this?
Because it's funny. It's hilarious. You're not gonna come and take my tree and put it in somebody else's yard. Now, is that what you said?
He says legally it's his. So we've got equipment to transplant it. We're gonna pull it out of the ground and move it over to his yard.
Hey. Wait, hold, what tree are you talking about? This is crazy. What tree, and who's Adam? So what's his address?
Well, he lives in the Blue House. I can't just give you all of his information.
No, I don't want his information. I got to know who I'm dealing with here. Nobody's going to take a tree out of our yard.
Oh, no, we're
It's not my tree. Did you get a hold of Michael and Kelly that own this whole property?
No, but
I'm just a renter here, okay?
I guess originally that tree was in his yard back in the 70s, and they moved it. So they.
This is so funny. I don't know. Are you sure you got the right property? Are you talking to the right guy? I think you're messed up.
No, I'm not. It's 50 Northeast.
50? Just a little house.
Yeah.
A little tiny house.
Yeah, we're taking...
What tree are we talking about? Let's find out what tree we're talking about.
Okay, well, you don't have to worry about it. There's nothing you have to do. We're just going to come there. We know which tree it is.
No, you're not... Have you talked to the person that owns the tree next door to me?
No.
My son, Michael?
No,
This is a joke, isn't it?
You can tell him. Like, just let him know.
Can I give you their number and you can lay this on them tonight? I think he might be home now. Let's see. He gets home around... Let's see if he's home.
Okay.
You're talking to the wrong guy.
Well, why don't
you want to talk to?
Why don't you call him?
I don't give a shit about the tree. I'm a renter here. Yeah, you're talking to the wrong guy, okay?
So why are you freaking
out? Nobody's going to lift a tree out of our property.
Oh, we definitely are tomorrow. We're coming tomorrow at 8 in the morning.
God, what tree is it?
Okay, what's would his...
Describe the tree. What are you talking about?
Tell me his phone number.
Oh, I'm so boring. 20.
All right, say it like a normal person. 2. Oh, he hung up. I didn't hear the last 4 digits. I was going to put his son on the line with us, but he got all offended that I was acting like he's boring, I guess. Anyway, thanks, Symphonium, for that idea. That was pretty fun. I'm going to have to do that one again sometime. I think I'm about done with these. I think it's time for voicemails. The show is probably getting kind of long at this point. I'm looking at these other ideas on here, like Snappy Bakes has an idea. She wants me to trick homeowners or irate residents into having to say, "Here I am, rock you like a hurricane." Like, what the hell is that, Snappy Bakes? That makes no sense at all, but I kind of want to do it. Mr. Biggs wants me to call up some veterans of our military and thank them for their service and allow them to tell me stories of their time overseas, then politely thank them again before saying goodbye. Oh man, I wish I had time to do that, Mr. Biggs. But we are just running out of time. I've got to wrap this up. I Regret Jumping wants me to tell HOA members that security is going to be tightened and they need to wear ID badges when they're outside of their homes, and visitors need background checks. That includes delivery people. Don't pet the roaming guard dogs. There are a lot of ideas in this Discord channel. If you look in the show notes on snowplowshow.com, there is a link to the PLA Discord. Everybody should join that and come in and say hello and try not to be a dick and get banned. There's a channel called Prank Call Idea Factory where you can put your own ideas into the channel, and maybe someday I'll get around to trying them out. But this channel's for everyone. I encourage all prank callers to go into this channel and steal ideas from it for your own prank show or just for your own amusement. Oh, here's a good one. You should call record stores and ask if they have any Prince records with his song Cream on it, and then tell them they should wipe it off. That is a good one, Patricia. I'm definitely going to be doing that one soon. Oh man, here's a really good one by Mr. Biggs. I wish I'd seen this one earlier. I'm going to pin this one to the top so I don't forget to do this someday. The city is introducing bats into the wild to control the insect population. All residents are required to drill 2-inch holes into their eaves for roosting bats to sleep in, and they have to return all of the bat poop to the city for recycling, of course. That's a good one. I've got to do that soon. Next time, Mr. Biggs, I promise.
Brad, it's Adam. I'm in Portland. First time caller, long-term listener. You're fucking funny when you're angry. But the voicemail message, a little bit boring. It'd be more offensive. Talk to you later. Bye.
Here we go again. Bunch of voicemails about the voicemail message.
Hi. Want to let you know, Brad, but I don't blame you. I forgive you. Even if you did kill John Bede Ramsey, it's not really your fault. I mean, yeah, he came right at you, and they should have known better than to report
this. She was asking for it.
That's it. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Hey, Brad.
Hey,
Corbin. I dig the new voicemail message, okay? Hey, it's Corbin. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Yep. I know.
So what I'm going to do is, since I got you on speakerphone, I'm going to stick my telephone into my sock and then beat you against my mattress a couple of times.
Oh, wow.
All right, okay. Ready? Here we go.
Can't wait for this. Sock.
Wee. Go away, PLA. Go away, PLA. Go away, PLA.
This is more than a few times.
Go away, PLA. Go away, PLA.
All right. Thanks.
Hey, whatever happened to the IRC? I really dug that place.
I think it still exists, because I remember one evening we were doing the Hang Up the Phone show, and a few of the IRC people showed up and just complained a bunch because they hated what I do now. It seems like the IRC people are always just pissed off that I'm not the same Brad I used to be. I don't hang out in IRC all day anymore. The nerve
hey,
of me.
Brad. It's Crimson.
Hey, Crimson.
So Thorn on the voicemails was asking, which episode of the Snowplow show had you calling people and saying that they need railings on their roofs
Yeah.
I think I found the episode. So the episode is on October 21st, 2014.
Wait, what is it?
It's on October 21st, 2014.
October 21st, 2014.
And the name of the show? Food Stamp Tacos. That's right. It's the same episode as the Food Stamp Taco Lady.
All right.
And you did the calls with Neon. And if you just want to listen to the call with Neon and you, just go on YouTube and type in Property Lawsuits with Neon and Roy.
Okay, let's do that right now. 8 minutes. I think I did more of these, though, didn't I, by myself, without Neon?
Hello?
Hey, Donna?
Yes?
Hey, it's Roger. I live down the street from you over on Petrus.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry to call so late. I have kind of a problem. I was jogging past your house, and I don't know, one thing led to another. I was on your roof, and I fell off your roof, and I landed right on your sidewalk, and I hurt myself.
Why were you on our roof?
Well, it's none of your business. What I'm saying is, you know, I hurt myself, and I don't know, I think it's kind of your fault. You know?
Just you think so, huh?
Well, I would think so. It happened on your property. Your roof was... There's no rails or anything along the side of your roof. I was, like, right at the peak. Right at the peak of the roof, and I fell off and landed on the sidewalk in front of the door.
Well, where do you live on Petrus, Roger?
I'm just around the corner. Like, kind of... I don't know. Not even 3 blocks. In the 7,000 block.
Oh.
Yep. So what are you going to do about it, though? I fell off your roof. And you're liable for this.
Just a minute here. I think I need a little more information.
Hopefully it's not just this one call that's 8 minutes long. I'm hoping there's several calls. I just want to play the first one. Okay, all right. Is it going to take forever?
Well, you know, he called in the middle of the night, so you're going to have to just be a little patient.
Okay, all right. Just please hurry, all right? Because I'm in pain, you know. You don't need to be grouchy with me after you, you know, hurt me this much. Oh my God, she's so slow.
What was that?
Nothing. What are you doing?
I'm trying to get some stuff.
What kind of stuff are you getting?
You call me in the middle of the night.
I know what time it is. I'm not retarded like you.
So let me just repeat all this, okay? So you were on the roof of our house for reasons that are none of my business.
It's in my jogging path.
You fell off my house onto my sidewalk right in front of my door, and you hurt yourself, and you feel like I owe you money.
Well, I hurt myself on your property, and that means it's your fault. Do you have insurance? I'm going to need your policy number.
Hey, buddy. You're not getting anything.
Yes, I am. I fell on your sidewalk.
Oh. Well, that was boring.
Hello, Mrs. Newton?
I don't want to listen to a bunch of these. I wasn't too impressed with that one. Maybe the other ones are better. I'm going to put a link in the show notes to the entire 8-minute video of calls about being on people's roofs. Remember, it's pronounced roofs. It's not roof. But I'll put that in the show notes on snowplowshow.com. Maybe the other ones don't suck. And by the way, people keep asking me what happened to Neon. Like, her website's down and everything. She hasn't done a show in forever. And I don't think I know exactly. I don't talk to her a whole lot anymore. But she showed up in our Discord the other day, and she was talking to us, and didn't act like the show was over forever, so maybe it's going to come back soon. I kind of miss Neon's show. Come back, Neon.
Property Lawsuits with Neon and Roy.
Crimson's still here.
And there's a shorter, like, 8.5-minute long video. And there you go. All right, see you, Brad.
All right. Thanks again, Crimson, for directing me to a really boring prank.
Hey, Brad, this is Jake calling East of the Rockies again.
I've called you
quite a few times already. I just want to let you know how much I really enjoy the show.
Thank you.
I've been looking into it, and I want to give you a donation, but I'm anti-Patreon just because of people that run it. I'm banned from using PayPal.
Just bring a suitcase of cash to my house. That's fine.
For some certain things.
My address is easy to figure out.
Quite some years ago. And I'm sure you have it listed somewhere, like a P.O. box or something we can send something to, but maybe it's something you should just play for all the listeners to hear and, you know, spread the message that way, man. I love the show, dude. listen every day. I'm still catching.
I took down my P.O. box for a reason.
Up on all the old archives and all the new stuff, but keep up the good work, brother. Love you. Cactus.
Thanks, Jake. Yeah, I guess if anyone wants to send anything to the P.O. box, I guess I'll give it out, but I try to just keep it off the website these days because I'm signed up for enough junk mail as it is. As hilarious as you guys think that is, I really don't need the billions of catalogs and stuff and information on Rogaine. Yes, I get the hint. Adult diaper samples. Every time I go to the post office, I just have to stand in there and throw all this shit in the trash can and take home my couple of legitimate letters. So sure, if anyone wants to send anything, it's Brad Carter, P.O. Box 465, Albany, Oregon 97321. Please be nice, because I'm seriously thinking about just getting rid of my P.O. Box, just using my home address like a normal person.
Hello, Brad. This is Red Eagle / Cobra.
Hey,
I'm calling. I have two things that I'd like to say.
All right.
One is that Onage Pranks, I don't know if you know this or not, he stole your Carnival Cruise prank. He did it with the same like style call. He chose a random absurd 90s celebrity.
Really?
As well.
That's crazy.
That was kind of interesting.
Is that recent? I'm looking on his page now and I don't see anything like that. I'd be honored if he took one of my ideas, though. I kind of like when people use my ideas. Anyone out there that wants to use my ideas, please do.
That worked out. I don't know if he saw your call or whatever, but he stole that one, definitely.
That motherfucker.
The other one is, you mentioned that you voted once in the group chat, but
yeah.
You didn't say who for, so I'm just going to assume that you wrote in Sensei Doug.
Of course.
Because I just think that would be the only...
And he didn't win the presidency. It sucked.
A way we could unify this the fan base is just to assume that. So you wrote in Sensei Doug, all right?
Yep.
Out.
Let's go with that. No, really, I just don't give a shit about politics normally. I'm not educated enough to be able to make decisions about politics. That's up to you guys that care about that kind of thing. I'd never voted in my entire life, and... A certain person that I was seeing back then convinced me to register and then vote. And I basically just let her pick everything. Hopefully, it's probably illegal to even say that. But I'm just like, I don't know any of these people. Here, you pick. All I know is that she did not pick President Trump. I don't know about anything else. Voting is way too much responsibility for me to handle. Fuck that shit. It's never happening again. That was the very last voicemail. And that was a really short voicemail segment. I'm so happy I changed that message. I think it really worked. I think people got bored and just hung up on the voicemail. They're like, wow, this voicemail's boring, and just hung up. You're welcome for that, everyone. Oh shit, here it is, Onage Pranks. I searched for the word cruise, and this is from 2 years ago. I'm surprised nobody mentioned this before. It's 4 minutes long. I'm not going to play the whole thing, but let's hear how this goes.
Hello?
Hi, may I please speak with Alicia, please?
My ass was calling.
I want to know who the celebrity is. I don't want to listen to all this.
Hey, this is Russell calling with Carnival Cruise Lines.
This is Alicia.
Yeah, I was calling regarding your upcoming reservation. I think you had two cabins reserved with us here in November. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Yes, we wanted to give you a call. We had a particularly noteworthy individual call in making some demands about booking some certain rooms on the ship. And unfortunately, we were forced to forfeit your reservation. And I wanted to call and see what we could do, or maybe give you an alternate cabin on a different ship, or kind of see how what
Why
we...
Why did you have to forfeit our reservation?
Well, you see, the individual did spend quite a bit of money for that cabin and paid quite the premium for it. It's actually just a really, really big celebrity that wanted that particular room.
Our room?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
It's just actually a really big deal for us to have Macaulay Culkin on our cruise and, you know, tweeting about it and that kind of thing.
That's a good one.
So we did, unfortunately, you know, have to forfeit the reservation to him.
He's no Pauly Shore, but come on, Macaulay Culkin.
Yeah, and it was a wedding. It's our wedding thing. And I doubt that Macaulay Culkin is making a reservation from today till November of next year.
What do you mean?
I don't know where you're. I don't believe you're calling me from Carnival, so I'm going to go ahead and call my reservation agent, and I'll go from there.
Have you seen Home Alone? Are you familiar with who this celebrity is?
I know who he is. I don't care. I really don't care. Right now, you're.
So the prank is that she doesn't believe it. Here, let me go forward a little bit.
Hang up on you, and I'll call my reservation agent.
Could I possibly talk to somebody more level-headed, like your husband, perhaps, or husband to be, rather?
You go and have a great day.
Ma'am, is that possible? Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Alicia, I wanted to tell you one more quick thing.
Uh-huh.
That whole call was a prank set up by Charlie.
That little monkey is going to get his ass kicked when I see him.
He pretty much said that you're going on.
So he does the whole reveal thing on the end of his pranks. I should try that. I'm going to steal that from Onage. I'm going to start saying this was set up by so-and-so. And the fact that it was a setup, that kind of means that he couldn't have stolen it because somebody submitted that to him. So whoever submitted that to me, they're the ones that stole the idea. Onage pranks fucking listeners. Anyway, thank you everybody for listening to today's show. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks to the sponsors of today's show, Teen Wolf Jesus, Xander Fett, Omni, SimSpeak, and 2020. If you'd like to support the show, you can do that by going to patreon.com/phonelosers or phonelosers.com/cactus. Every week I do an additional show just for the supporters called the Hobosodes, and they are occasionally funny. You're missing out if you're not supporting the show.
While we're on the subject, could we change the subject now? I was knocking on your ears, don't be you, we're always out.
Oh, give me a fucking break.